How do you know summer's here? Because it's no longer the Velveteen Duck that's running this show, it's a roast duck. Sorry everyone, I haven't been publishing videos for the last few weeks because it's simply too hot to run my PC in this tiny little room. But hey, time to get back on schedule with the Summer Solstice Festival event. As always, if this video helps you out, leave a like, subscribe, and share with your friends to support the channel. The Summer Solstice Festival event is a multi-part event. You'll start with the Summer Solstice Preparation event, which is where the grind is. This part of the event will run for a week from July 12th to 18th. Start the event by heading to King's Hill, where you talk with Simon Clammer, the town crier. You'll also get some quests from Festos, Sir Hardy, and a variety of merchants such as Edmund, Amelia, Grismick, Zumpy, and Nob. If you've never played this event before, spend some time killing worthy monsters to pick up some fairy tickets. Or if you're just rolling in dough, then you can always buy some from the shop with Andermans and skip the grind. Once you have fairy tickets, head to Kalodoro. You need one ticket per entry, and on Bloodshed mode, you need 10 fragments of Infernal Passages too. Now, just a word of warning, okay? There is literally one map for this entire event. The first few runs are going to be pretty dry, but as you turn in more quests, you'll get more elite monsters spawning on the map and eventually bosses. So make sure you turn in your quests when you finish them. Event progress drops on this map are also crap. So make sure you're picking up the 4 different colored powders and turning them in for event progress. A couple of tips for tackling this map. There is a quest that involves torching tents. If you stand too close to the tents when you torch them, you'll take some fire damage. Also, there's a small chance of a greedy goblin spawning out of the tent, so have some higher tiered essences ready if you don't have a lot of damage. There are also amphorae scattered throughout the map, including the occasional cursed amphorae. Lastly, some of the quests are repeatable only once every 24 hours, with it resetting at server reset time, but are a pretty good source of things such as event progress and solar coins. You can also get Summer Solstice tokens from the event progress bar, purchasing it from Grima, and as a pretty rare drop. Hold on to those solar coins and Summer Solstice tokens. By the way, if you can't find them, solar coins are located in your currency bag, and Summer Solstice coin go in the special bag of your inventory. You'll spend these in the next part of the event, the Summer Solstice Festival. When the Summer Solstice Festival event activates, all unfinished quests from the preparation event will vanish. This part of the event will only last for 2 days, July 17 and 18. Disclaimer for those of you who are actually interested in finishing the event progress bar. You pretty much need to spend money if you really want to finish it. There's an event attire that makes progress drop, and without it, I'd suggest treating this event as a sightseeing tour. You won't be able to finish the progress bar. During the festival, Kalodoro gets converted into an urban area, sporting numerous merchants, a fishing minigame, and 3 adjacent maps. Let's go over these one by one. Starting with the merchants, you can purchase all kinds of goodies. Depending on how far you are with the game, different items will hold different value. If you're a complete new player, consider investing in some basic pets at Grismick to collect your pet bonuses from your collector's bag. If you have premium, consider the treasure collector pet that helps to pick up gems. There is also 2 very interesting items. One is called the Summer Scroll of Equipment, which can be purchased from Zumpy or Grismick. The other one is called the Premium Summer Scroll of Equipment from Amelia. Each of these lasts for 30 minutes, and it will make the unique or set item from that merchant become a possible drop from the reward chests of the 3 adjoining maps. This is important because this is the only way to get certain items such as the Zeal uniques at a level higher than level 100. Yes, that is right, you can actually get Zeal uniques at level 140 using this item. If you want to use these scrolls, make sure you have a lot of minigame tickets and fragments of Infernal Passages ready to spam runs as quickly as possible so you don't waste the 30-minute buff. In Kalodoro, you'll also find the fishing minigame. You'll need fishing rods, which can be purchased or obtained from the three maps adjoining Kalodoro to fish for prizes. Most of the time, you'll get some small, crappy rewards, but the most important reward you can possibly get are those passes to the three adjacent maps. And if you're super lucky, you might even get a Summer Solstice token. There is also a choice of 5 different chests that require 10 Summer Solstice tokens apiece to open. Each box can only be opened once, so I'll just show you the rewards of each so you can decide which one you actually want to open. Going counterclockwise, we start with the jewel box. I had the dubious honor of opening this chest twice. First time I got the Jewel of Ghost Power, which is kind of useless unless you have the appropriate Halloween event uniques to pair with it. The second time I got a Jewel of Relentlessness, which is also kind of useless if you use the Blood Mage talent. At the gem box, I received a number of high tier gems. At the pet box, I received the Melon Pug pet. At the mount box, I received the Summer Solstice horse. And lastly, at the rune box, I received 5 runes. Now let's talk about the 3 maps adjoining Kalodoro. All of them are solo maps. Your group cannot enter with you. Starting with the underground casino, chamber. You can go in here and gamble on the chesses. Pick a chest. If you're unlucky, all the chesses will disappear. If you're lucky, you'll get a chance to light the brazier near the entrance and claim your rewards. Just gonna say it, I think this is the worst possible map to pick since it relies purely on luck. And I am not lucky in this game, apparently. Moving counterclockwise, there is the Meanie Rumble. Monsters spawn in waves and you have to kill them quickly. If you kill them within the time limit, you proceed to the next wave. At the end, some chests will spawn with rewards. This map is difficult if your character has low damage or slow attack and run speed. And now for the third and final map, the Arena of Endurance. This is probably the easiest map of the bunch. You can't use your skills in here, and offensive effects such as the Jewel of Poisonous Thorns is also disabled in here. All you need are defensive stats, such as health, armor, block, and HP regen. Avoid being hit by the flame trap, whirlwinds, and lasers. The monsters in this map actually deal the least damage, but make sure you don't get trapped in their midst. If you do die, or once you finish the challenge, chests will spawn with the rewards. So, if there's anything that I left out or I wasn't too clear about, leave it in the comment section below, I will answer. And for those of you who otherwise want to talk, come join Discord, link in the description. And with that, enjoy your summer full of roasted duck.